Hi friends and welcome back to my channel. In previous video we had discussed about the conformal mapping and we had solved some sums related to the conformal mapping. In today's video we will be discussing about some special types of transformation. So today's video will be about W is equals to Z square transformation, which is a special type. Okay, in next video we will discuss about W is equals to Z plus 1 upon Z, the other type of special transformation. So without any further delay, let's get started. So the first type of special transformation is W is equals to Z squared transformation. So this transformation has two parts. First is the Cartesian form and second is the polar form. So in Cartesian form, W is equals to Z squared transformation can be written as U is equals to X square minus Y square and V is equals to 2XY, where U is the real part and V is the imaginary part. Okay, so this is the, I will write here, this is real part and this is imaginary part. Now in polar form, this W is equals to Z square transformation can be written as R, capital R equals to small r square and phi equals to 2 theta. You will understand this transformation when we solve sums related to this polar form polar form of W is equals to Z square. Okay, now I will give a hint that when we have to use the Cartesian form and when we have to use the polar form. So Cartesian form is used when the equation of the line is given, okay, and this polar form can be used when the equation of the circle is given. Okay, so remember this. So now note an important part that whenever in the Z plane the equation of the line is given, then we can convert this line by using W is equals to Z square transformation into the parabola of the W plane. Okay, so now we will see the Cartesian form of W is equals to Z square transformation. Okay, so we will derive the equation for the Cartesian form. So let's say W is equals to Z square is given. Okay, now we know that what is W? W is equals to U plus IV. And what is Z? Z is X plus IY. Okay, whenever in this chapter you get W and Z, then you will replace W with U plus IV and Z with X plus IY. Okay, always. So this is U plus IV and this is, if we open the bracket, then we will get x square plus I into y the whole square plus I into 2xy. Okay, so this is u plus iv and this is x square minus y square. Why minus? Because I square will be minus 1. Okay, so x square minus y square plus I into 2xy. Okay, so now we will separate the real and imaginary part. So on the left hand side you will get the real part as u, on right hand side you will get the x square minus y square. So u equals to x square minus y square. Okay, now on the left hand side you will get the imaginary part as v, this v, and on the right hand side you will get the imaginary part as 2xy. Okay, so we will write it together. So v equals to 2xy. Okay, now this, up to this step, in every equation of W is equals to Z square transformation is important. Means we have to derive U and V in every equation which is related to the W is equals to Z square transformation. Okay, this step is known as the separating real and imaginary part. Okay, so write it down. Then we will discuss the polar form. Now this polar form is very easy. Okay, so W is equals to Z square is given. Now we know that W in the polar form can be written as capital R into e raised to I phi and Z can be written as R into e raised to I theta. Okay, we had derived the polar form of Z in the previous videos of complex variable and complex function module 1. Okay, so go and see that. So this is the whole square. So now R is equals to small r square. Okay, and phi which is equals to 2 theta, because I will write this will be the square and this will be 2 theta. Okay, so from this equation you can see that capital R will be equals to small r square and phi, this phi will be equals to 2 theta. Okay, so this is the polar form and this will be used when the equation of the circle is given. Okay, so now we will solve some sums related to the W is equals to Z square transformation. So the first question is, find the image of the region 1 by 2 less than equals to x less than equals to 1 under the transformation W is equals to Z square. Okay, so now you can see here the equation of the line is given. Okay, line is given. So now by using this transformation, that is W is equals to Z square, we can convert this line of the Z plane into the parabola of the W plane.
Okay, so now we will start.
So the solution will be, so W is equals to Z square is given. What is W? U plus IV. What is X? What is Z? Z is X plus IY, the whole square. Okay, so we will expand this bracket. So we will get U plus IV is equals to X square plus I into Y the whole square plus 2 into XY into I. Okay, now this U plus IV can be written as X square minus Y square. Y minus because I square is minus 1 plus I into bracket 2XY. Okay, so now we will separate the real and imaginary part. So this U and this is real part, and this V and this 2XY is the imaginary part. So U is equals to X square minus Y square and V is equals to 2XY. Okay, if you do this much step in the question, you will get the 1 mark. Okay, for this much steps. And so now we will move here. X is greater than or equals to 1 by 2 and X is less than 1 is given. Okay, so first we will take, let X equals to 1 by 2. We can take X equals to 1 by 2 because here X is less, X is greater than or equals to 1 by 2 is given. Equals to is sign there. So we can take X equals to 1 by 2. Now when X equals to 1 by 2, U will be, so U equals to 1 by 4 minus Y square, and V will be this 2 into 1 by 2 into Y. This 2 and this 2 gets cancelled. So V equals to Y. Okay. So we can substitute Y equals to V in this equation of U, in this equation of U. So U equals to 1 by 4 minus V square. Okay. Now we will bring V square on the left hand side. So V square equals to 1 by 4 minus U. Minus 1 common. So we will take U minus 1 by 4. And this is V square. This is the equation of the parabola. How? I will show. Now the standard equation of the parabola is given as Y minus Y0 the whole square equals to 4A into X minus X0, where X0 comma Y0 is the vertex of the parabola. Okay, so this is the standard equation of the parabola. So you have to remember this standard equation. Okay, so now we will compare this above equation with the standard equation of the parabola. Now what is Y0? First we will see X0. So X0 is 1 by 4. Vertex is 1 by 4. Y0 is 0. So it is 0. Vertex is 0. Okay. Now 4A. 4A is any constant term. So here it is minus 1. Okay. So 4A can be anything. We are worried about this bracket. Okay. 4A can be anything. So we had obtained the vertex, that is 1 by 4 comma 0. And V square equals to minus of U minus 1 by 4. So this parabola will be negative. Means this parabola will face the negative U axis. Will face towards the negative U axis. I will show the graph. So this is U and V. I will mark the vertex 1 by 4 comma 0. Now it is minus. So it will face the negative U axis. Where negative U axis will be on the left hand side. So it looks like this. This is the parabola of V square equals to minus of U minus 1 by 4. Okay. I hope you got the idea. So now we will see for X equals to 1. Okay. We had obtained one equation of parabola for X is equals to 1 by 2. Now we will see for X equals to 1. Okay. Now when X is equals to 1. When X equals to 1. Okay. So what will be U? When X equals to 1, U will be 1 minus Y square. What will be V? V equals to 2Y. V equals to 2Y because X is 1. So from this equation, Y equals to 1 upon 2 into V. Okay. So now we will substitute this Y in the equation of U. So U equals to 1 minus 1 upon 4 into V square. So it is 4 minus V square divided by 4 into U. So it will be 4U equals to 4 minus V square. Now we will bring V square on the left hand side. So V square equals to 4 minus 4U. We will take minus 4 as common. So minus 4 into U minus 1. So this is V square. Okay. So this is the equation of the parabola. That is V square equals to minus 4 into U minus 1, because y minus y0, the whole square is equals to 4a into x minus x0. This is the standard equation of the parabola, where x0 and y0 is the vertex of this parabola. Here, the parabola is negative, and it will face the negative side of the u-axis. Okay, so this is the second parabola when x is equals to 1. So now we will draw this both the parabolas and the line. Okay. So these are the graphs. Okay, this is in the W plane, this is in the Z plane. So this is the parabola. The outer parabola is representing the equation v square equals to minus 4 into u minus 1, and the inner parabola is representing the equation v square equals to minus of u minus 1 by 4. Okay. So from this equation, the equation of the lines are x equals to 1 by 2 and x equals to 1 in the Z plane. So this inequality shows that x is the region between these two lines. So this is the region between these two lines. This region is converted using the W is equals to Z square transformation into the parabola of the W plane. So this region, the red region in the Z plane, is the transformated region by using W is equals to Z square in the W plane. So this red region is the transform region of this Z plane region. Okay. So I hope you understood this. So in next video we will discuss some other sums of W is equals to Z square transformation, and we will see the other special type of transformation. Okay, so that's all. If you had any doubts, please ask me in the comment section. Please subscribe my channel for more educational videos. Like and share. Thank you.